So in today's tutorial, I've been trying to come up with a really easy Halloween tutorial because I've been short on time this year, but I still wanted to make something for a costume. So I thought that this super simple cloak would be the perfect way to go. It'll go with so many different last minute ideas. I paired it with a masquerade mask, but it would look so good with a queen and king costume, or if you did a bright color, it would be a great superhero cape. So it's super versatile, and I just love the way it turned out. It's just so simple, but so effective looking. So I really hope y'all enjoy this tutorial, and if you do, please give the video a thumbs up, and let's get sewing! To make this cloak, I used almost 1 3/4 yards of this beautiful velvet fabric, and I love velvet for an elegant look, but you can use any fabric you'd like. My fabric had some stretch to it, but a non-stretch fabric is fine as well. And you'll also need about 1.5 yards of 1 to 2 inch wide ribbon to use as a tie. Begin by deciding how long you want your cloak to be and measure from your shoulders down to where you want it to end. I wanted a full length cloak, so I measured down to my feet and got 55 inches. Add 3.5 inches to your number to add the room we need to hem the bottom edge and to feed the ribbon tie through the top edge, so I got 58.5 total. Now decide how wide you want the cloak to be, and there's no science to that, it's just a matter of preference and how you want it to look. I wrapped the tape measure around me with a few different measurements and decided that 48 inches would be a good width for me to still show off an outfit underneath. Add 2 inches to that number to add room to hem the sides, so I got 50 inches total. Cut out a rectangular piece of your fabric that measures the number you got for length long by the number you got for width wide. We'll be hemming the sides of the cloak next, so to make it easier to show on camera, I've turned the cloak on its side and zoomed in here, and I know it looks like the fabric was cut at an angle, but it's just the way the camera was sitting. It is a rectangular shape. Make sure the wrong side of the fabric is facing up and fold the side of the cloak over 1/2 inch once, then fold it over again another 1/2 inch so the raw edge is no longer visible and pin it down. Double fold the next section 1/2 inch at a time, smooth out the fabric and pin it into place too, and repeat that process of double folding and pinning all the way down the side of the cloak. If you're using a non-stretch fabric, it may be helpful to iron the fabric as you fold it to get it to stay, but make sure to check the ironing instructions for your fabric first. When you've pinned the entire side down, sew along the fabric to secure the hem. A standard needle and straight stitch will work fine on non-stretch fabric, but if you're using stretch fabric, you'll need to use a ballpoint needle and either a stretch stitch or a zigzag stitch, which will allow the seams to stretch without breaking. Now that one side is hemmed, go to the opposite side of the cloak and repeat that process of double folding the fabric, pinning it down, and sewing, so now both sides are hemmed neatly. Next, we have to make a casing for the ribbon to go through along the top edge of the cloak, so I've zoomed in closer here and laid it with the wrong side of the fabric facing up. Fold the top edge of the cloak over 1/2 inch, then fold it over again another 2 inches this time and pin it into place. Fold the next section 1/2 inch first and then 2 more inches and pin it down, and repeat that process of double folding and pinning, smoothing out the fabric as you go until the entire top edge has been pinned down. When you finish pinning, sew across the fabric, keeping your stitches close to this bottom folded edge to create a tube that the ribbon will go through shortly. If you're using a non-stretch fabric, sew this seam with a straight stitch, and if you're using stretch fabric, sew it with a zigzag stitch so the seam will be able to stretch with the fabric.
Now that the top and sides are finished, go to the bottom edge of the cloak and hem it as well by double folding the fabric a half inch at a time, pinning, and sewing to secure the hem using the same stitch you used on the sides. So now all the edges are finished. Grab your ribbon and hook a safety pin on one end. Push it in through the opening of your casing and use the pin to feed the ribbon through the cloak's top edge. When you pull it out of the other side, remove the safety pin and scrunch up the fabric around the ribbon to create a gathered effect at the top of the cloak. Tie it into a bow around you to finish the project, and you have the perfect accessory for any costume or cosplay. Thanks for watching, and have a safe and happy Halloween!
This tutorial, I've been trying... School bus. So many different tutorials. Wait, no, I can't talk today. Okay, I give up. Hopefully the intros I already had are good enough.